15. Well, it renders that two values into this part. So in a way, it renders the roundy round corners and the drop shadow classes into this part of the, let's say, parsable PRP file, which is going to be a CSS file. So it's parsing all these values to this file, and it's done with, for example, colors for certain for the fonts. It's done with backgrounds. It's done with what can we see more? Yeah, well, it's with the boxes. Well, let's see about these boxes I told you before. For example, here I make just a regular CSS class. It's a class, it's not an ID, it's a class with a dot. And here I say render the values of the box 1 CSSP. Well, that's again what I showed here. It's the box 1 CSSP, and it renders the boxy 1, the roundy 10, and the shady 15. So it puts it in this area. So this file, this CSS index, is being filled with all these variables, all these values from the value file. And I told you about colors. Well, this is the color part. It's what it says here. For example, the body background color for the website, for the page, is in this case this value. And this is the background color. It's, by the way, not, yeah, it's in this case there's also a background image, and that's the gradient. So the background image of this site is a gradient, and that's right, because you see it's gradient from dark to light. But for example, if you put there if we take it away, for example, that's maybe a good example for this. And we save it. It takes away the gradient, and it shows just a regular color. And that's the color that's written over here. That's just the regular background color. If we give it, let's say, a more darker gray color, you notice, well, it should change. I think the colors were just too much. Let's give it a completely different color. You see it's changing to black in this case, just by changing the value file. So you only change some values, or you only have to change some values in the value file to make it a complete different scheme. And that's so you don't have to do that much in any other files. It just some in the values file, and maybe some addition in the CSS file, but that's it. You can also add your header image just in this value file by adding it here, and also, for example, your link color, your header color. It's all done in here. Some little detail that's maybe nice to know. There's some future plans to make also sort kind of scheme editor, which where you can with the front end choose all these values for these different elements. But that's going to be in probably next version of the VIA template framework. There's some more. There's here some cursors. You can also put here, for example, images, and then it will show the image as a cursor. You can change the form, button colors, etc., etc. So it's fully modifiable and customizable in a way. It's been already a long story about this, so I'm gonna make it a little bit to an end. So this is how to modify and customize a scheme and the yeah, and adding their your own values in it. This can be closed for now. Let's save it for the fun of it. So yeah, and for example, this file, this CSS index. Be aware and especially be warned with changing anything in it, because it can completely mess up the whole site. Because this is very important file. That's yeah, can make nice things, but also bring a lot of damage to the site. So that's the whole scheme story. So it should be still fine by now. And with this, I also want to end this this tutorial movie. Yeah, this is all I wanted to say to you about it. So, to be short again, news items in the home, the latest news items. We did something with the RSS box, and you now know how to add your own schemes and modify them and make their own schemes. If you have any further questions, you can always send an email from the yeah, posting something on the contact formulary on the Van Allerlei website, or go to the VIA MDS website and also send there some message or notes